Nashville and good morning and welcome to the Nashville Daily Podcast. I'm your host, Stuart Deming, and today's episode is brought to you by ExploreTours.com. If you're wanting to learn the history of downtown Nashville, you need to come take a walking tour with ExploreTours.com. We will see the Tennessee State Capitol, the Ryman Auditorium, the Second Avenue, the Country Music Hall of Fame, the Nashville Symphony Center, and so much more. It's a two-hour-long tour, and you can book your tickets for it at exploretours.com. Use code ND10 to take 10% off your online order today, and that's for the Nashville History Walking Tour. Joining me today in studio, I'm going to mess up your name, Josh. Dang it, I messed it up. I'm losing it. Palais.
Perfect.
I said it right.
Yeah,
okay.
You did it good.
I always confuse that T and that E all the time.
Everybody does.
So you are the owner of JP Media Group.
JP25 Media.
Media. And so tell me exactly what you do.
So back during COVID, like everybody else, I was bored. And my dad has a studio at our house. I was living with my parents at the time. And we said, let's do podcasting. My dad's a broadcaster. I wanted to get into broadcasting. He already had a studio in the garage, like I said, so it was an easy transition. We went from audio to video. We started recording our conversations that we'd have every day in the house. And then my friends joined and some of his friends joined. And now we have JP25 Media. We are a podcasting platform. We like to have people come on our website. We do podcasting for them. I do all the editing right now. Eventually, that's not going to happen. But for now, I do all the editing. And it's a father-son thing. My dad's my best friend. And it's something that we do in memory of my brother who passed away in 2018. So the JP are my initials, but they were his as well. His name was Jake Palais. And 25 was his baseball number. So JP25 Media is for my brother.
That's awesome. And the title of today's episode is From California to Nashville. And so tell me the journey of what brought you from California to here.
So it's pretty interesting. I am born and raised in San Diego, but I went to college at Alabama. I was a football player for the Alabama Crimson Tide. So I had a little bit of history in the South, but Alabama wasn't for me. My dad's family's from Nashville, and I've been in Nashville my entire life, you know, for the holidays or just maybe once a year to see my grandparents. So my grandma lived here, and my grandfather passed away in 2018. So she was by herself, and she was lonely. And I felt bad for my grandma because I really never had to had the opportunity to see her that many times because I lived in California. So I said, I want to live with my grandma. I want to keep her company, keep her alive in some sense, and hang out with her, get a better relationship with her. And also, I can't afford a house in San Diego. So there's no way at 27 years old at the time I was going to be able to buy the house that I wanted. And in Nashville, I thought, you know, this is a better opportunity for me.
Yeah, very cool. I had the opportunity to live with my grandma for about 8 months. And it was probably the memorable time I've ever had in my entire life.
Probably ate the best food you've ever had in your life.
Oh, hands down. It was every time I walk in, my grandma will be like, and I have an Italian grandma, and she's like, are you hungry, Stuart? And I'm like, yes.
Yeah, and you're never full. She'll just keep feeding you.
Just all the time. And it's it's meat, it's pasta, it's all of these things. And it was just an incredible, memorable time for me.
Yeah.
And so with that decision to come to Nashville, what was it like playing football for Alabama?
It was insane. So I was a baseball player always. I walked on for the Alabama Crimson Tide because my aunt went there that lives here in Nashville as well, and I was always a fan. They offered me a walk-on spot, and when I went there, I thought, this is crazy how everybody in the school knows about the football team. They know the stats. The girls in your classes know about the team. In California, it is not like that at all. People are like, oh, yeah, like you play for the school. But for there, it's like, oh, my God, you're like a big-time celebrity at Alabama. So it was a big transition. And then living in the South compared to California is a huge transition. So that was a big adjustment, but it was fun.
Well, let's talk about that transition. So what are some of the differences? And a lot of people already probably know this, but what are the differences from living in Southern California to living here in the South?
Okay, the first thing that caught my eye was saying hello to people. So if you say hello to somebody in California, a stranger, they'll look at you like you have three eyeballs and you're weird. Here, the norm is to say hello to people. How are you doing? Thank you, ma'am, sir. You know, have good manners. In California, it is not like that. People are in their individual bubbles, kind of like you see in New York City. Yep. California is much like that, too. Here in the South, people are more welcoming, nicer people.
What are some other observations that you've made about differences?
Well, there's bad things, too. In Nashville, there's the worst drivers I've ever seen in my life live here in Nashville. Me and my girlfriend, we call it Crashville, because every time we go to downtown, it seems like there's a car accident. But besides that, the people here are super nice. That's one thing I really love about Nashville. That's why I want to have a family here in Nashville, is because people are more of a community. But in California, it doesn't feel like that at all.
From a cultural standpoint, do you feel the people of San Diego are more passionate about like what they do and like the purpose of life, or do you feel like people here in Nashville have more of a desire and more of a dream?
People in Nashville have more of a dream and more of a desire.
Could we define that a little bit more?
Yeah, for sure. So when I'm in California, I feel like people are very easygoing, very happy where they are. You know, there's obviously people that are driven everywhere you live, but there's a lot of people that just like being where they are and they're complacent. In Nashville, for example, very few people that I meet are actually from Nashville. So when I go to the gym or I go out, people are saying, oh, I'm from New York City, or oh, I'm from Florida, wherever. They're usually not from here. So they moved here. They want more for themselves. I feel like that's what I want for myself as well. So when I meet people, I feel like they're more like-minded like me.
So some other cultural differences. San Diego is a coastal city.
Mm-hmm.
It's known for its incredible museums.
Mm-hmm.
Nashville is not known for its incredible museums. We have three. We have the Country Music Hall of Fame, actually four. We have the Country Music Hall of Fame, the National Museum of African American Music, Musicians Hall of Fame, and then our only art museum in town is the Frisk Art Museum,
mm-hmm.
the Visual Art Museum. So talk about that type of cultural difference between the art scene in San Diego and the art scene here in Nashville.
I'd say there's more culture in San Diego because there's more people that are from San Diego. So there's a lot of people have their families have been there for a long time. There's a lot of Mexican culture, obviously, in San Diego. You're bordered right next to Mexico. I mean, there's tons. All my friends in San Diego are almost Mexican. So that was a cool thing. A lot of people speak Spanish. Here, there's not as many people that speak Spanish. But the thing also about Nashville that I love is people don't really care where you're from. They just love you. Like, mm-hmm. I feel like I'm loved on everywhere I go. In San Diego, it doesn't feel that way. And it's a big tourist city, San Diego. So San Diego is a very weird place because you have the surfers and then you have the military. And you put them together, it's like very opposite people in San Diego. But San Diego is a great place, and I'd love to live there again. But Nashville, for me right now at 29 years old, is the place to be. And from a culture perspective, everybody loves me here. And nobody's mean to me here in Nashville, except the people on the road that drive that want to crash into my car. But besides that, people are fine here.
Yeah, it's we tell everyone a lot on the podcast to invest in dash cams because
100%.
They get you out of situations that, first off, you probably shouldn't be in or somebody else caused. So let's talk about in the landscape of politics in California. California is extremely divided right now. There's a bunch of laws being passed that a lot of people are disagreeing with. Was that more of a public-facing thing in San Diego compared to here? Like, what? Talk about that realm.
Okay, so I think Nashville and San Diego are on complete opposite sides. So San Diego, or California's a blue state,
mm-hmm.
correct? So that's the difference, but the...
Nashville's a red state with a purple city.
Yes, so San Diego is a Republican city, which is very interesting because you're in a blue state. And you're overshadowed by bigger cities like Los Angeles.
And that's most likely because of the military base.
Exactly, because of the military. Nashville is the complete opposite, right? Like you said, it's a red state with a lot of liberals here in Nashville. So that's the difference. For me, I just want peace. Like, if you want to feel one side about politics, that's fine. Just don't bring it into my life. I won't bring my views into your life, just like religion. I respect your religion, but I don't need you to tell me what religion you are. You want to rub it in my face. I just want to live my life. So just be respectful. That's the only thing I ask.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So how long have you been here in the city of Nashville then?
Almost 2 years.
What's been the highlight of living here?
The highlight of living here is the kindness of the people that are here. Like I said, the coolest thing about Nashville that people don't realize compared to California is that there's a lot of trees also. It makes you happy.
Yeah.
Yeah. And San Diego, there it's a desert, obviously. So Tennessee has a lot of trees. Makes you feel good. But the biggest highlight of being here is people ask me how I'm doing. Like I said, that's a big deal to me. When you play sports, when your coach asks you how you're doing, it's a big deal to you that you want to feel like people care about you. And here I feel like people care. And having my family here and getting a better relationship with my grandma has been worth it for me.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Okay, so now let's talk about some Nashville neighborhoods. What's your go-to Nashville neighborhood? What's some of your favorite eateries? And, yeah, we'll just go from there.
Okay, the most underrated area of Nashville for me is 12 South. I love 12 South. I feel like people obviously know what 12 South is and people go there on the weekends. But 12 South to me is an area to hang out with your friends when they come in from other cities. When my friends come in from California, I like to take them to 12 South. It's actually where I met you at, was on 12 South. I lived in Brentwood when I first moved here. I think Brentwood's a great place to be. I can't afford Brentwood. definitely can't afford Brentwood, but that's where my grandma lives. And I live in Donelson. I think Donelson's an up-and-coming area. I like where I live right now. But 12 South, I think, is one of the best areas to take people from out of town. Obviously, everybody wants to go to Broadway, and I understand that. But 12 South is an underrated spot. Eateries-wise, I don't go out to eat as much as I should because there's a lot of great places to eat here in Nashville. I like Geist for brunch. I think Geist is underrated as well in Germantown. They got a great menu. They got great food. They got a great vibe.
I've never been to Geist.
You've been everywhere, so I am shocked.
I have been everywhere, but I've never been to Geist.
We're going to go to Geist together.
Okay.
Okay. So Geist is great. Me and my girlfriend, we love it.
Is it right there on Jefferson Street?
Dude, I'm the worst with streets.
Okay.
It's right.
Is it near the baseball stadium?
Yes.
Okay, I think I know exactly where it is.
It's kind of by Von Elrod's.
It's right next to it. Yep.
Yeah, so it's a great place. And we're going to go now. Like, I'm putting this in my schedule after this.
What type of food is it?
American breakfast and brunch. But they have a good vibe. That's a good thing about Nashville, too. Every place here has, like, an open concept restaurant. Yep. I feel like a lot of places do with patios. And I like the vibe of just being outside, the natural.
I assume San Diego has a ton of patios.
Not as many as you think.
Really?
No, because they're so limited on space, they can't have patios. Everybody is so close to each other.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, I had the only California city I've been to was L.A., and I was there for 24 hours, and I stayed in the airport. I interviewed for the television show Big Brother.
Nice.
And that was a mistake. Thankfully, I did not get on that show because I think that would have drove me crazy. It was interesting because interviewing. Have you been on an interview for a television show like that, like reality TV? So you go, you can't talk to anybody at all. So you can only talk to staff members. So everyone that's interviewing for the show, you can't talk to them. So like when you're going to the restaurant, you get escorted down to the restaurant. Dude, it was bizarre. And then you sit there and you fill out this 3-hour psychological evaluation.
Why?
I have no idea. To see if you can play the game. And then you meet with the producers of the show. And it's a room. You're sitting in this room and there's like 6 individuals and they're asking you these questions. You have like a 35-minute conversation with them. And the question that they asked me, and then I got on a flight the next morning because I answered the way I answered. They said, Stu, are you willing to lie, cheat, and manipulate? And I said, no, I'm going to play the game honestly. And the next morning, I was back in Nashville. So it was really interesting because they found me through Instagram. And that's how I interviewed with them. But, like, the starting process was I did an interview in this random hotel room in Nashville. And then they flew me out to L.A., did the interview in L.A., and then had to fly back to – it was just a bizarre experience.
That sounds really weird.
Yeah.
Was it uncomfortable?
No. No. I'm not uncomfortable in those situations, so it's...
Hold on a second. You flew to L.A., they put you in a room where you couldn't talk to anybody, filled out a 3-hour test, and they flew you back, and that wasn't uncomfortable?
No.
Okay.
I've been in more bizarre situations.
Really?
If things are going to happen, they happen to me. So, like, and I know a lot of people say this, but, like, I've been in situations multiple times where... I was in the JFK airport, and a guy next to me was arrested for terrorism. And so, like, a lot of scenarios in my life have caused me to be in these situations. So,
yeah,
that's bizarre. So, have you been able to get out and experience Tennessee and just outside of Nashville?
I'm laughing because the reason I have experienced the things I have is because of your page, Explore Nash. When I first moved from California, I wanted to know what was going on nature-wise. I like hiking. I like going to waterfalls, stuff like that. So I typed in best waterfalls in Nashville. And then you did a top 10 of the best waterfalls near Nashville. Yep. And I took my friends to Cummins Falls. It was the best part of their trip to Nashville, all thanks to Stuart. And that's how I got into, you know, what's going around Nashville. What's the best way to find out what's going around in your city is to go to social media, go to YouTube, yep, Instagram, and find people like Stuart that are going to do the hard work for you.
It's an interesting space that we're in. We were, I think, one of the first nationwide channels dedicated to Nashville, mm-hmm, or actually to a particular city. Like, you have, like, Thrillist, and you have, like, these 6 a.m. and all these big corporate people that have millions of dollars. But we were the first, like, YouTube channel, from my research, that was dedicated to the city. We weren't a travel blogger coming and going through the city and talking about the highlights of this and this. We were dedicated. And it's just an interesting space because of the amount of tourism stuff I've been involved with in the city, and Aaron's background with film and broadcasting. So it's just that perfect blend. So that's awesome that you went out. So you've gone to Cummins Falls. What other waterfalls have you gone to?
I've been to Burgess Falls, and I was supposed to go to three waterfalls last week, but it rained. So I'm looking to make that up when I get
back.
The
rain hikes are worth it.
Why?
Just because it's fun going through hiking in the rain. The rain hikes are worth it, and then the snow hikes are extremely worth it when they happen.
Okay, I don't know if you heard, but I'm from California.
They're rare.
So, yeah, I'm not big for cold weather, but yeah. I'll take your word for it.
When you're doing the snow hikes, make sure to have proper
I'm not doing it.
clothing on.
I'm not going.
Also have the shoes on and get the hiking spikes where you're not slipping as much.
Yeah.
So what's one thing from a nature standpoint that's different than California besides the trees?
I like open space. That sounds dumb, right? But in California, you're so limited on space, especially within the city of San Diego. There's so many buildings. Here, there's so much open land. Like Shelby Bottoms, to me, is like mind-blowing because there's so much room to walk and just explore. I feel like Percy Warner Park is endless. I like going to Percy Warner Park. It's underrated as well. It's not underrated. Everybody likes Percy Warner. Radnor Lake is awesome because there's nothing like Radnor Lake in California. You have the beach, but you don't have lakes like that. And the way that there's so many like hawks and turtles, I feel like such a little kid. I just point out all the little deers and stuff that. But that's the biggest difference for me.
So San Diego doesn't have like a wildlife preserve near the city?
No, it's a desert, so it's not like that at all.
Okay, very interesting. Yeah, I have to get out there sometime to experience it. Where can people follow you on social media?
Yep, so you can follow me on Twitter and Instagram at Josh Palet, the way it's spelled, JOSHPALET, and then JP25 Media, our company, on Instagram and Twitter and Facebook, but especially YouTube, JP25 Media.
And then you have how many podcasts and stuff that you have on there now?
We have about 5, but we're trying to expand. So if you have a podcast that you'd like to have on our channel, contact me at Josh Pelle.
Okay. Josh, thank you so much for coming on to the show. Head over to NashvilleDailyPodcast.com to see the show notes of today's episode. Also, book your tour today at ExploreTours.com. Use that code ND10 to take 10% off. And if you're interested in subscribing to other YouTube channels, head over to Explore.Nash. That's XPLR.Nash. We have valuable information over there about waterfalls, food, attractions, and so much more. We'll see you guys tomorrow. Thank you for listening to the Nashville Daily Podcast. If you want to learn more, head to NashvilleDailyPodcast.com.
You can also follow us on social media at Explore.Nash on Instagram, Nashville Daily Podcast on YouTube, and Explore.Nash on YouTube as well.
The Nashville Daily Podcast is an Explore LLC production. Copyright 2023.